Hi there, just wanted to post a quick tip about the feature array tool. I have as an example here a little custom wheel I'm designing, and I need to put the bolt pattern on it for the bolt holes. And I showed you one way to do this is using a bolt circle. I want to show you a new way to do this. If I go ahead and open up a sketch, and I'm going to go ahead and get perpendicular to that sketch, and I'll just go ahead and make a hole by using my extrude cut feature. So I'll put my hole there, I'll dimension it. Say half inch bolt, and I'll put it, let's see, 5.5 inches divided by 2 away from the center of the wheel, and I'll put a sketch relation on that to make it directly vertical. Okay, so fully defined sketch, I can go ahead and cut that hole. Okay, and I'll just say through all. All right, so it's cut a hole through there. And now I need to have 5 of these bolt holes going around in that feature pattern. So what I can do is I come up to my toolbar here in the command manager, and if I hold the little arrow down, I can see a circular pattern. And I select the feature I want to pattern. I want that hole cut, and I then select the circle around which I'd like it to be patterned, and I can select any edge there. And I choose the number of holes that I want. And I can either have them equally spaced, as I have here, 5 inches, or I can have them spaced by a number of degrees, right? So 15 degrees apart, there's 5 of them. And I want them equally spaced, so I'm going to go ahead and click check. And there you go. Now I have 5 bolt holes spaced out evenly there. This is a pretty boring looking wheel, so I'm going to go ahead and add some more holes up here. Maybe I want some larger holes, just kind of for decoration. Go ahead and dimension these just like I did that last one. Maybe we'll make them 1.5 inches, and I'll put a radius on this of 5 inches. Looks like it's about good. Okay. Again, add my sketch relation. We want to work until that drawing is fully defined. There it is, fully defined, turns black. I'll cut that through, and I'll just say through all. Okay. And now I can do that pattern again, circular pattern, choose my features to pattern, and again remember the blue box over here shows you what's active. And now I need to choose the circle about which to pattern it. I can also choose a curved surface, and rather than 5, I think I'll go for something like 10. Okay, so pretty basic wheel there, but much easier than defining each of those circles and having to draw them out. I can just cut one circle and then use the circular pattern to finish it up. Hope that helps. Have a good day.